and learn about their long and storied lives. So I was really looking forward to interviewing Clarence Gogan. What I did not expect is that I would want to kidnap him and take him home with me. He was engaging, entertaining, fun, and a truly remarkable man. If I were to tell you all of his accomplishments, we would be here well past supper time. So here are a few highlights. Clarence was attached to the Army 10th Mountain Division, which specialized in fighting in mountainous and Arctic conditions. He trained soldiers to ski, fought in Germany, and served in the Aleutian Islands. In February, a plaque at Mount Wachusett was rededicated to this illustrious group, and Clarence was present, receiving a ceremonial bottle of bourbon, which I got to see at his house. His athletic talents were not limited to the ski slopes. He was also an ice hockey player and a competitive speed skater. He trained the famous Olympian Arthur Longstreet and skated with Carmelita Landry. He was a terrific golfer with holes in one to his credit. Visiting Clarence's home, you will see an abundance of trophies, plaques, and medals attesting to his abilities. Clarence also opened one of the first Saab dealerships in the United States, one of four. Clarence has been with his wife Blanche for nearly 75 years. When I asked him the secret to the longevity of their relationship, he answered, "I keep my mouth shut." How can you not love a man like that? It is my privilege to present to you the newest recipient of Lunenburg's Boston Post-Kane, Clarence Gogan.